I had a customer ask me recently, say to me recently, "Hey, Todd, I have a building management system. I have a lighting control system. Why do I need an intelligent building? What's the difference? What do I gain?" And I thought that was a really informed, question to ask. And I thought that would be a great way to start, would be to get your perspective on, what's the difference between where we are today and where we need to go to create intelligent buildings, and what do customers gain from that?
That's a great question. And the interesting thing about that is there's still no real cookie cutter answer to that. An intelligent building certainly means something different to everybody. But I actually like to compare buildings to cell phones for a second. And what I think is incredibly interesting about that comparison is at this point, most people have a smartphone. And I remember when they first came out, the adoption was a little bit slow. Why do we need this? And so on. And now what's created the long-term staying power of that cell phone is the fact that it adapts to you. For example, I could start texting you and it would really write the whole text for me before I even get my fingers on the screen. It knows what I'm going to do before I do it. And we've never had that situation in buildings. We have various degrees of automation through building automation systems and abilities to tie different systems into each other. So if a camera sees a person, perhaps it locks a door, triggers a card access or a door lock to happen, or environmental controls, things like that. But now with the technology that's available, that's really proven and deployed in multiple areas, more as siloed, when we bring that together, we can truly have that experience where, like a cell phone, our buildings start to adapt to us.
Yeah, I really like that analogy. I think that helps. It's something, a consumer technology that we use every day, that gives us some perspective on what intelligent building means. And I think, in that vein, Bob, I think what people are trying to understand today is, from a workforce perspective, if I'm someone that's working in a building that's an intelligent building, what does that mean for me? What will I experience? What is that cell phone-like experience that I will gain? And it probably could mean a lot of different things to your point, but let's start with that perspective. What is that user experience like inside an intelligent building?
Right. And that user experience could be something different for everyone. If we want to break things down by generation, we have plenty of baby boomers who have smartphones, and plenty of baby boomers simply use their smartphone just like the old flip phones to dial a number, and that's the end of it.
Right.
Whereas on the other extreme, we have our millennials and our Gen Zs that have now come into the picture where that's all they've ever known. That's what they live on. They have an app for everything. And the phone can adjust to their daily pattern. So same thing here in the workforce. When we look at things like spatial utilization and increased productivity for our workforce, where the building recognizes you as you come into the building and can actually assign you a spot within the building, a cubicle or an office collaboration type area based on that particular day's agenda or itinerary. And then configure that space to your likes, whether it be digital photos, your phone access, your network capability, even right down to an LED QR code where you can scan into it with your smartphone that then changes to your name and title. Beyond that, it gets into things like internal wayfinding or GPS within the building, helping you find things like conference rooms or other people within your organization, all geared towards making you comfortable. Understanding your lighting preferences, whether that's the temperature of the light, your environmental preferences, maybe you like a little cooler, a little warmer, and being able to adjust that along with your peers to make as many people as possible, as comfortable as possible in the area, leading to more productivity, happier employees, and even healthier employees.
Yeah, that individualized feeling that there's this dialogue between the building and the user. I think that is that real change that we're going to start to experience or are experiencing with intelligent buildings.